Hello guys, welcome to another episode of Learn Technology in 5 Minutes by Makerdemy. This is Arvin and I am part of the instructor team at Makerdemy. In this video, you will learn about a wireless technology called Zigbee. Before getting into the video, I am sure that you are familiar with short-range wireless networking technologies like Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, which are used to connect devices. These technologies are fairly mainstream today and are used in specific use cases. For example, if you want to stream audio, you're likely to use Bluetooth. Likewise, if you are streaming video or larger files, you're likely to use Wi-Fi. But let us think of a use case where we can connect a large number of battery-operated devices. Is it okay to use Bluetooth and Wi-Fi? The answer is clearly no, because Wi-Fi consumes a lot of power and is therefore not ideal for battery-operated devices. Most of Wi-Fi devices, like your mobile phones or laptops, are usually charged on a daily basis. Then what about Bluetooth, you may say? Well, Bluetooth consumes less power than Wi-Fi. So, would that not be ideal for our case? But you can connect only a limited number of devices to a Bluetooth network, and therefore, Bluetooth is not ideal for our case as well. So what could be a better solution to connect a large number of battery-operated devices? Enter Zigbee. But what exactly is this term Zigbee? Zigbee, like Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, is a short-range wireless protocol. The Zigbee is built on top of IEEE 802.15.4 physical layer and is designed to meet the needs of low-cost battery-operated applications where longer battery life is the major concern. Unlike the other two technologies, Zigbee operates at a very low data rate of 250 kbps. And this low data rate is the trade-off we need to live with because we are planning to optimize for low-power network protocols that can connect many devices. A single Zigbee-enabled device can reach up to a range of 10 to 20 meters indoors in search of another Zigbee device present in the network. The Zigbee operates in a mesh topology, which helps a Zigbee device to transfer its messages to its destination via a number of intermediate Zigbee devices connected within the network. So what is mesh topology? Don't Wi-Fi and Bluetooth follow this? Well, in basic sense, topology can be termed as a way in which devices are connected to each other. In a mesh topology, there is a coordinator that sends the information, an intermediate device which carries forward this information, and an end device that receives the information. All the devices in this topology except the end devices can communicate with each other and are also able to change the paths to deliver the information if any disturbance occurs in the network. Whereas in star topology, there is no intermediate device and the communication is done directly between the coordinator and the end device. This disables the chance of establishing an alternate path to transfer information at the time of failures. Wi-Fi and Bluetooth are configured as star networks, whereas, as already discussed, Zigbee follows mesh topology. There are two advantages to using a mesh network. First, a mesh network increases the system reliability. Second, because of the way transmission happens in a mesh network, the short range of individual Zigbee devices stops being a problem. We can add a large number of Zigbee devices which need to transmit data just to the neighboring node. This way, very large networks can be built based on Zigbee. In fact, the Swedish city of Gothenburg is a giant Zigbee network where over 250,000 homes are connected together for the purpose of remote energy metering. Coming to the security associated with Zigbee, it uses a 128-bit AES algorithm to encrypt and authenticate the message signals via the links, which are secured by special keys, allowing the end user to use the device in a secure manner. So where do you think Zigbee is being used? Well, it is extensively used in smart homes to remotely access electronics and also in smart metering. That is all from me in this video, folks. If you like this video, then subscribe our channel and ring the bell so that you don't miss any videos from us.